Hello, I am Sandra Camelo Piragua. I'm one of the neuropathologists here at the University of Michigan, working with MLabs. I have been a neuropathologist for more than 10 years, and we have a very vibrant and very cohesive group of neuropathologists. Thank you for trusting us to take care of your patients. We want to just reiterate the importance of preparing the specimens and providing us with clinical information so that we can better serve you and your patients. So here at Michigan Medicine and MLabs, we are unique because we are people who come from different backgrounds. We have been trained and served different in different populations and different institutions. We have a combined experience of more than 30 years for nerve and muscle pathology. In addition, we have a wonderful and very knowledgeable technical staff that really care and take good care of every sample because they understand that behind each sample there is a patient, there is a person, could be a relative or any one of us. So we take a good pride on taking care of each individual case separately. So that's why we think that set us apart. In addition, we provide a very comprehensive study for nerve and muscle biopsy. And for us, it's imperative to have appropriate clinical history, be able to communicate with you, the pathologist, or you, the clinician, to discuss the cases. We are open to discussion before, during, or after we have reviewed the cases with the objective to answer the clinical question you may have. Nerve and medical muscle biopsies are unique and are a little different than the rest of surgical pathology. So it is very important that our clients follow the kit's instructions. In fact, I recommend that if the clinician or the pathologist know that the procedure is gonna happen, they contact us in advance in case they have any question about the procedure or how to collect or how to send us the specimen. It's better to clarify those issues before that, during, or after the procedure has been done. It is important that specimens are properly labeled with patient's identification and, very important, the site. The histopathologic features can vary depending on the site of the body that has been biopsied, and that's why also having the clinical information is very important as well, because we want to correlate how the clinical presentation and the either the muscle or the nerve that has been biopsied correlate. So for muscle biopsies, remember these are medical muscle biopsies, so it's different than if it's a neoplastic or other type of lesion. So these are not gonna be handled as any other surgical specimen. So please discuss with the surgeon what is the muscle group that is gonna be biopsied. Ideally, it's a muscle group that is affected, but it's not too affected, so that is totally end stage and we cannot tell you exactly what's happening. Communicate with the surgeon that it's important to take the biopsy from the belly of the muscle and not too close to the tendon insertion, because this introduces some artifacts that may mislead in the diagnosis. Make sure that the muscle biopsy is not taken from where the needle EMG was performed, because this can also introduce some artifacts. If it's the pathology department who's gonna divide the muscle in three pieces, same thing, please reach out to us. And for the clinicians or surgeons, make sure that the specimen is procured and sent to the lab as soon as possible. Once the muscle is retrieved by the surgeon, it is very important not to let it dry out. So just covering with a little bit of wet gauze is all we need, but please do not, under no circumstances, please do not put it kind of floating in saline solution, because this is gonna introduce lots of artifacts and it in fact can damage the tissue. So just cover it with a little bit of moist gauze is sufficient, and send it right away to your pathology department, and then they will handle it from there in terms of the fresh specimen. So, for example, for nerve biopsies, the nerve is going to be sacrificed. It's going to be biopsied entirely. So please, communicate with your surgeons not to be shy in terms of what's the size that is needed. I know we require kind of a large piece of nerve biopsy, but think about that this nerve is not gonna be functional anymore in the patient, and it's gonna be that very important piece of tissue that is gonna hopefully give us the information of what the pathology the patient has. So please communicate with your surgeon and let them know to take a sufficiently enough large specimen. And then please follow the instructions as provided in the kit. Not to twist the nerve, because it can provide a lot of artifacts. It's also very important not to let the tissue dry out, but quickly follow the procedures and put the different parts of the specimen in the different containers provided. Finally, I want to thank you for entrusting us with your patients, and we are here for you, and we're here for your patients. And as always, you can give us a call, send us an email if you have any question before, during, or after the specimen has been sent to us. Thank you.